So this is a special moment for me, Paulo, because we've had such a long career where a lot of times our paths were intertwined. You know, we had to, the entire purple belt year, the entire brown belt year, and then that final match where you beat me, and it was like, that was like the final match, and that was the one that it meant so much to both of us, I think. And it was a important experience for me to lose like that. And it was one of those losses, and I'm not trying to make this about me right now, but it was one of those losses that like really made me appreciate my competitors, and like competing against you and your brother was always it was a real honor, because I didn't see a lot of people out there that had that same focus that I was trying to achieve. And I always thought that you guys had even more of a focus. But during that period of my life, from 2012 to 2013, basically, we fought like 9 times. It was like a crazy long, year-long battle. And you and your brother were always so focused and diligent in it. I think you both set the bar of like the concentration and the focus needed to really be a world champion. And I think that's something that, I mean, you always got a lot of credit for it. Like everyone would talk about how focused you and your brother were, and it was always just about the training, the jiu-jitsu. And I see you guys are still like that to this day, but maybe a little more relaxed and open to like doing other things, which I think is awesome and healthy for you guys. Mm-hmm. And now you're at this point where it's like you've been world champion. You've never really shown a lot of like your secrets, really, because like you must have spent 40,000 hours on the mats over the course of 10 years, maybe more. I think most masters in jiu-jitsu, they only put in like maybe 10,000 hours on the mat, but you live on the mats. Even when you don't live on the mats, because you have lived on the mats, but even when you don't live on the mats, you still live on the mats. Mm-hmm. It's like your second home. So can you tell me just like, where did you get the strength to have that crazy focus? Like, where does that come from to really like laser in on this goal and never let up on it? Where does that come from?
I mean, it's a hard question because I think I was born like that, you know? Always when I do something, I try to do my best. I always try to... And I have my brother. I think, for be honest, I think this answer is going to be always my brother, right? Because he always pushed me. And of course, I have a lot of competitors like you, like Rafael Mendes, like Guilherme Mendes that I looking when I was like a lower belt, you know? But yeah, I think the main thing was having my brother, but I think it was something like I was born to, you know, to be the best that I can, whatever I do, you know?
Yeah, I totally agree. So a lot of, for when people have a technique that is their focus and their specialty, like you don't just do Barambola anymore. You have a very dynamic, well-rounded game now. But in that time that you were really building that system and learning to understand it, what was it about just the movement in general of like the actual inversion and taking the back? Why did it attract you? Why did you really kind of find yourself move towards that rather than something more conventional? Was it just the times because like Hoffa and all the other guys were kind of doing it at the same time and you just kind of picked up on it? Or was there something about it that you really stuck out to you?
Yeah, because like you say before, I don't have like a strong passing game. I don't like to go to be on top. And I think the easiest way to like win a fight without like be on top is like try to go for the back right away. So I think it was because this I end up like doing burn ball and that, all this stuff, you know?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
And that makes total sense because it's like the shortest path between two points. It's like, how do you win? Take the back and that's it. And,
exactly.
I've jokingly criticized Barambola in the past for this reason, because it's like you have to focus on it so much, and then it can leave some of your other game parts of your game undeveloped. But I do think for people that really want to do Barambola, you do have to have that kind of laser focus to get really good at it. Do you think? Would you agree that it's like a high skill cap technique? Like it takes a lot of time to like grow and become really effective with the Barambola, or do you think maybe with what you showed today, do you think it can kind of shortcut it for people? What's your view of it?
Yeah, of course, what I showed was the basic Barambola. It's when the people have to start. Yes, and I think if the people want to be really good on the Barambola, like you say, they have to spend a lot of time in training, a lot of time in drilling, a lot of time trying to do in competition and training, you know? But I think I make a mistake to focus too much in burn bolos, focus too much in the thing, and let my game just to like passing guard or whatever in black belt. So I recommend a balance too, you know, yeah, always balance. A middle ground about to do just one technique, you know. I don't think it's good for you.
You just started learning jiu-jitsu recently and you've reached a conundrum. There's too much out there. Where do you even start? Some of these websites are advertising for 10,000 videos. They've got 10,000 videos. Do you know how much time it would take? I did the math. It just says boobs. And honestly, that's what you're gonna be if you try and make it through all those videos. You need something more concise. It's a misconception. Quantity is not what you want. You want quality. And the only way to have quality is to have someone, a curator, to show you what's actually valuable, the good stuff. That good stuff is hard to find. That's what Jiu-Jitsu X does for you. It organizes huge amounts of data, huge amounts of information. Look at all this. There's so much of it. On Black Friday, when you see all these sales and numbers and save by buying, save by spending, it's counterintuitive. There's a million of this, a million of that. No, no, no. Focus. What do you actually want? You want to improve at Jiu-Jitsu. You need to have a plan. You need to have a strategy, and then you need to execute on it. We offer that strategy. We offer that plan. All you have to do is execute on it. Go to jiu-jitsu-x.com. jiu-jitsu-x.com, 40% off, Black Friday sale. Now's the time. Don't f*** this up. Yeah, what do you think the best way to like balance it is? Like just in training, try and do it all, drill everything, or like how do you go about actually finding that balance?
Because like for me, what happened was this, like I spent so much time doing burn bolo, and I realized even I stopped to do a burn bolo and trying to like doing pass or whatever, my burn bolo is not gonna be affected, you know, like because I have so much hours in training. So I think the people have like to be like maybe 50-50 about everything, you know, like trying to pass and try to be on bottom, even not just do burn bolos, you know. When I be on bottom, I have to try to do like a lot of submissions too, a lot of like normal sweeps too, you know? Just not be like depend off just one technique, you know?
Yeah, absolutely. Mm-hmm. And I also think that it's something that, even though I have said in the past that it can be like, it kind of becomes this black hole of time and effort and energy, and then you can get so good at it, sure, but then it's like the other pillars of your jiu-jitsu are not maybe not as cultivated. I do recognize that it's still an important movement that everyone should know, because it's not just burn bolo, but inverting in general, knowing how to invert and how to enter into leg entanglements or just any sort of the entire reverse de la Hiva game and the waiter sweep inversions and worm guard inversions. It kind of comes across everywhere. You do have to learn it. So today you said you kind of focus more on like the fundamentals of burn bolo and like providing more of like a platform to like grow from there. Is that what you said?
Yeah. So I show some drills too for the people do when they are trying to learn the burn bolo, when they're trying to begin. And I show some advanced techniques too, when the people is like more advanced than they know about the inversion, about the burn bolo and this stuff. Yeah.
Yeah. We have a lot of people who, when they're looking to learn and like buy instructionals or learn from things, they're kind of looking for answers, you know? They're on the mat, they're a little confused, maybe they don't know how to be super effective. I think something like this, where burn bolo really is very much a one-stop shop full solution to win. Like if you really want, like if you're trying to win quickly, burn bolo is where you should practice, especially if you're a little guy, because it does kind of apply from everywhere. You can always get to the position no matter what. So I think that's super cool. What's up, Miha? So now, what kind of techniques do you work on now? Do you still kind of cultivate your burn bolo game, or do you work other guards? What kind of other stuff you're working on these days?
Yeah, in my recent competitions, I did a lot of warm guards, like. And I tried to combine like warm guard, going to the burn ball. Mm-hmm.
How's that working out? Do you like it?
Yeah. I remember you gave me like a tip in the Spider Korea. You remember?
I don't.
What no, happened? Yeah, what with happened? Jonathan Alves. Yeah.
But tell me, what was the tip? What did I say?
Was about the... I'm so confused about names, so it's like when you do like kind of reverse de la Hive and you pass the lapel and try to keep the Nidega guy inside, you know?
From
so,
reverse Della Worm,
Yeah,
that was super cool to see you and your brother start doing Worm Guard. You guys kind of started doing it. You were the second like black belts to actually use it, you know, in competition at the highest level. So that was super cool to see you guys do. Mm-hmm. I still Barambolo to this day, just not as much in competition, but I do try and do it a lot in training. Well, thank you very much for coming out. I hope you had a good time. We hope to have you back here soon to film some more stuff. One thing that we like to do is if you ever come back and you want to do another instructional, we can like update the Barambolo course so you can have some new stuff. And so people who buy your course, they can kind of like get more things in the future next time you come back to film with us. So.
Yeah, I just want to say thank you for you guys for the opportunity. It was an amazing time with you guys. Yeah. Thank you so much.
And you did one other instructional in the past, but you haven't really done any other ones?
No, this is like my first in 6 years or something.
Wow, so this is a big thing. Like putting I like to compare, like people like us who come up with these systems and like have these things that we really understand on a very deep level. The only way to really, there's two ways to express the art. It's like in competition, you can express the art, but it's like, it's fleeting. It's like a small, you can do one thing here, one thing there, and it's very difficult and stressful. Yeah, but then there's the other canvas of art, which is like teaching. And it really gives you the time to kind of like organize your thoughts and think about like, how are people going to receive this expression of your art, you know? And like, we train this stuff so long.
Exactly.
So I think it's a beautiful thing to be able to put that out there and like let people actually learn from your immense knowledge that you've collected over the last, how long have you been training now? 15 years, probably?
No, 11.
11?
11 years, yeah.
Yeah. How old were you when you started?
I started with 18. Yeah, 18, yeah.
Great. Jiu-jitsu. How old are you now?
29.
Nice.
Yeah.
It's almost masters.
Yes.
Here we go.
Next year, masters.
Awesome. All right, thank you, Paul.
Thank you, Keenan. Thank you, guys. Thanks so much.
My name is Keenan Cornelius. You may know me from KeenanOnline.com and also from the Lapel Encyclopedia, which is where I keep all of my lapel guard secrets. We're transferring everything over to Jiu-JitsuX.com, the new website. And on this website, you can see that my courses are available individually. However, most people, when they engage with my content, they're looking more for an overall broad spectrum of all of my jiu-jitsu that I teach. So now, for the first time ever, we're taking all of those individual courses from all 14 of the Keenan Online courses, plus the Lapel Encyclopedia, and connecting them all into one super bundle. This crazy value of upwards of $1,600 just right now for this one time for $240 on a yearly subscription. Now is the time. I hope I never have to do this again. If you're looking to have one of the most comprehensive jiu-jitsu instructional bundles ever created, all together in one, here it is. Go buy it.